Now since I cannot have this thing every time, what I can say, up now, I will have the feel of a rotor. This is my rotor on which my two conductors are there. Both the conductors are there. So since I can see this the waveform of this is very fluctuating in nature. So to improve the waveform of this DC, I can have multiple number of conductors on the same rotor. If I have two more pair, one here, so what will happen? Rather than getting this waveform, from here only I'll start getting a waveform of like this. Again, if I have some more conductors on the rotor, my waveform will again improve. So I can see that my waveform is continuously becoming a straight line. It is in almost a form of a straight line, though it is having a fluctuation, though it is having some ripples. But from the previous condition, when I was having two conductors, my whole DC was fluctuating. Now it is fluctuating in a very small manner. So the more the number of conductors would be there, more lesser would be the DC ripples. So I'll be having n number of conductors at that time. So this conductor A is internally connected to be this conductor. This conductor is connected here. This conductor is connected to this. This conductor is connected to this. So that So that I'll be having different form of DC, and this form will be almost a straight line. So now coming to the commutator again. Commutator. I can have the feel of a commutator now. This is my center of my rotor, which is having a key so that the rotor will not come out. And these are the slots in which my rotor conductor are resting. So I can have a full rotor now. I can have the armature, I can have the full rotor now, and I can have the commutator segment also. Previously I said that when I split that one ring into two parts, because there was only two conductors at that time. Now since I am having one pair, two pair, three pair and four pair of conductors, one pair, two pair, this is three, third and fourth pair, there are four pair of conductors now. So I'll have four pair of commutator segment, means total number of eight parts of this conductor segments. How it will be? This will be connected here, this will be connected internally here, this will be connected 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 here, like this. The total conductors will be connected to the total number of commutator segments. So one more thing comes into picture. Now that where whatever be the number of conductors, that will be the number of commutator segments. So if I'm having 100 conductors, so it, then I have to have 100 commutator segments also. Sorry. So this is a very important point to remember, that the number of conductors should be equal to number of commutator segments should be equal to number of commutators, number of conductors. So now coming to the brushes. As I already said that brushes, when we have not discussed that point now. Sorry. So now coming back to brushes, I have to keep my brushes in such a manner that there should not be any voltage when there is a commutation going on. Commutation is what? When we saw in this diagram, when previously when I was talking about the generator. Sorry, when I was talking about the normal generator, an AC generator, before the commutator segment, sorry, there is a problem with me. So when I was talking about the commutator, before commutator I was getting this waveform A to B, B to C, C to D, B to A, and when I put the commutator inside, what happened, rather than getting B to C here, I was getting B to C here. I was not getting this thing. So this point was very important at that point, these two points. When there is a process of commutation going on from where the phase is getting changed, I should not be having any voltage here. The voltage was zero at that point. So that from B to C and C to D, there was no voltage at the brushes. So at this point, the commutation was very good. If this is not happening, then there is a circulating current under the brushes, and brushes will be having I square R losses. The brushes will be heated up very quickly, and there will be a lot of wear and tear in the brushes, and due to the circulating current, and since the coils are there, they are having inductors react and axle, so the sparking would be there in the brushes. So I need to keep the brushes here in some such a way that there is no voltage at that point. Again, coming to some lesser number of poles, lesser number of conductor, so that we'll be having a better idea where to keep the brushes. So I have now only two again. My commutator segment is like this now. My commutator segment is split again into two parts. Now I'm having two conductors only. So I'm having two commutator segments only. This part. This part is here. and this is my another commutator segment. To have a better idea, I will have a bigger space here. So two conductors are there, so only two commutator segments are there. Now, since I said that the brushes should be placed in such a way that at the time of commutation there should not be any voltage generated at the brushes, VND. So I at this point, since at this point in closely we can see that the point P and D should are those point where the commutation from AC to DC is happening, or from the phase is getting changed. The phase was getting changed here. This was the point C previously. So from B to C, C to D, B to D, B and D are the points where the commutation was there. So according to that, this was one point A, this is point B, this is point C, and this is point D. So automatically, I can say that the brushes should be placed on this line, which is called as the magnetically neutral axis. Now, this is the word which is very important. Magnetically neutral axis means there the magnet are neutral at this point. There is no flux on these two points. We have already seen that. At these two points, the flux was zero. So at this point, I can place my brushes. I can place my brushes and I will take them out. I will take out the wiring from these two points. I have taken out the wiring and these points will be the where my load will be connected. This is the case when it was 2 volt machine and only 2 conductors are there. What happens when it becomes the conduct poles will become more and the number of conductors are there, more conductors are there.